morning.
Good morning. I'm Presley Mama. I'm the Presley Mama.
Really?
Yeah.
Lots of them.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You can not on the program?
He said yes.
Oh, he said yes. Music and Appalachian style Mountain music, and we provide free lessons and
jumpstarting my whole summer full of music. I've been in the studio all day today recording, so I'm so glad y'all made me get up early to get a kickstart on my day. But I hope that this is also the start of a beautiful weekend for yourselves. And I'm going to sing some original songs. I wrote these songs growing up here in the mountains of North Georgia and North Carolina. And I did spend some time in Nashville where I actually learned how to write a song and then came back here to get inspired. So hopefully you'll hear some of that inspiration in some of these songs. This is a song I wrote. Sitting on the back porch at my granddaddy's campground where I was raised over in Hiawassee, Georgia, looking out the beautiful mountains one night. It's called Alba. I was trying to get somebody off my mind and I ended up thinking about them all night long. This is what came out. Snake. If you've never seen it, it's pretty interesting. It's about this certain part of Christianity, I guess, that or denomination that pretty Pentecostal, they believe if you hold the snakes and have faith that they don't bite you, that they won't bite you. And it's kind of like a fear factor inside the church is what I would say. Anyway, this particular preacher, who was a pretty violent man at home, he had a great congregation, but he was a pretty violent man. He actually went on trial for either murder or attempted murder because he forced his wife's hand into the rattlesnake pit and they came to their house. And he claimed it was an accident. Anyway, there's a scene in the documentary where the son, who was talking about his abusive father, said this awesome phrase, and I wrote it down, and I was like, I gotta put that in the song. But he said, he cast a big shadow. It was hard to hold up to. And I just love that idea of just, I don't know, this big, fearful man casting this big shadow. And so I wrote this song this week. This is brand new, and I haven't shown many people, so I'm going to share it with you. If you're okay with listening to a new song based on a pretty graphic, dark documentary. What a better way to start off a Friday morning. This song is called Big Shadow, and I kind of just made up the story of this person who's passed on. And but anyway, I hope you like it. Yes. for listening. Well, I grew up on my granddaddy's campground, like I said, playing the fiddle and learning the clog. My brother and I were championship cloggers by the time we were 10 years old. We had clogged all over the southeast, and we wanted to play baseball, but my granddaddy said, no, I'd rather you join this clogging team, and I'm glad you did that instead. And so clogging was one of my great joys growing up, and of course, clogging so much, I fell in love with fiddle music. So I had to learn how to play the fiddle. So I'm going to play a song for you that I wrote last year right after the pandemic started. I was sitting at home, and I live alone, so I was by myself for that first month, and I wrote this song on the violin. You like it. It doesn't have a title, so if you think of a title, if something hits you, let me know what I should call it.
Thank you.
this song. You can go listen to it online. It's called Daisy. I don't like it, but I hope you like it. It's not singing for you. It's not horrible, but it's just, it's not completely me. But I was inspired. My mom loved daisies, and every time I would see a daisy, I would think of it. So this song is kind of inspired by my mom.
Thank you.
she said, well, there's something you don't see every day. A train sitting on a train track. And the way she said it just sounded like a song to me. I just laughed and I said, well, where else are you going to see a train, Mom? And she said, well, what I mean is usually you're having to wait on the train to go by. And I remember my mom grew up with a railroad track not too far out from their yard, and my granddaddy was always screaming at his kids to get out of the railroad track, you know? And anyway, I just thought it was a wonderful sentence, and I said, please write that down in my little songwriting notebook. She was in the passenger seat, and it sits in my little pocket on the door there. I try to keep one everywhere I go in case I get inspired. Well, she kind of rolled her eyes. Well, about 6 months after she passed away, I was cleaning out my car and found that little notebook that I had forgotten all about. And I was flipping through it, and the only page that had something written on it was in my mom's handwriting. It said, there's something you don't see every day, a train sitting on a train track. So I went home that night and wrote this little song that is kind of in the style of Bob Dylan's You Ain't Going Nowhere. It's got four incoherent verses tied together with a sing-along chorus that still makes no sense. And so I would love for you to sing along with me since I've already told you the lyrics. Here's a train track. My name, once again, is Wyatt Espalin. Thanks for listening and thanks for having me, folks.
Thank you.